Kelvin Areola in the CX Racing FCRX7. Ooh, Kelvin. It's exploding that front bumper. As it says on his windshield. Dang. Uh-oh.
The goal today is to assemble these three boxes. This took about 2 hours. I'm still left over with some dowels and some screws, but I mean, everything's accounted for. Our messy garage. We have to swap diffs for the upcoming track event next week at Chuck Wallace Speedway. So let's see. Alright, so I believe this is David Yu's LSD, Celica Supra LSD that I still haven't put together. Sorry, David. This should be a 5-3 welded, and this is my 3.9 LSD, right? And the car currently has a 4.3 welded. That's not gonna fit very well. We're gonna try to catch it. This never works. Anyways, I'm gonna try to save this oil because I just swapped the diff. So this fluid should still be good. Alright, so we're gonna take off our fill plug first. If we don't, then it won't breathe. Let's crack the drain plug. Alright, let's try to catch this. We're gonna try really hard not to make a mess. Okay, we're catching our fluid. Josh, you're on the vlog. Okay, these axles have been in and out of this car a bunch of times, so let's see. Okay. First axle out. Okay, I was going at a good pace, but then I decided the car is too low, I need to lift it up. So I gotta get this jack, and these tires are in the way.
Cracking them loose by hand, then I'll go around with the air ratchet.
A jack with a jack. This is just to break the seal. Should probably put a nut. There you go.
All into this box. Hopefully. Nope. Not at all. Okay. There we go.
This is the good stuff.
How do we do this?
We just do it right.
Okay.
The two nuts are in here. All right. Brake bracket aligned. Right. Same thing on this side, get our brake bracket aligned. Actually, these rear brake pads are actually for a Chevy Cobalt SS. They're just Hawk pads I found for cheap and decided to mill them down to fit. Oh, you know what's funny too? This is the rim I welded. So, check out this amateur weld repair. There, all the way to there. And if you notice, these tires have a good amount of camber wear, toe wear. I actually dug these out of the junk pile at Apple Valley Speedway or Grange, right? Because I can't afford to have Van Diovas. So maybe we're leaking from the tire. Either way, I'm just gonna rock them. So, I got this funnel
Ew, look at that nasty funnel. Okay, so I got this funnel. What I do is I shove it in this hole. Get your dirty sock. Wipe down that nasty part. You get the hose in the hole. So this is actually the fill plug. Hopefully that's an angle. Okay. Just gonna snug it. We're gonna get this oil that we saved earlier. Right. Then we're just gonna reuse our oil. I'm just gonna top it off and try not to make a mess. Literally set it and forget it. Top it off a little more. Make sure the e-brake's on or you have a wheel shock. So when you lower it, your car doesn't come and crush you. Ask me how I know. So I rewelded these wheels again for the 100th time. We're gonna see if there's a leak. Barely making a seal. Right? The wood underneath. And we got this big gap here, but let's see what happens. Okay, we got brake cleaner, throttle plate cleaner, and we got a torch, propane torch. Might need another can. Got one here just in case. Wait for this. So far, I don't see any bubbles.